Today, the seat of power, India's national capital region, Delhi, is historic, and that is visible everywhere. In iconic architectural marvels like the Qutub Minar and thousands of other monuments that are scattered around the many cities that formed Delhi. But even amidst all this well-known splendor, there are historic sites that are lesser known, with stories to tell. On a humid morning, I joined the founder of the Youth for Heritage Foundation, photographer and LHI columnist Vikramjit Ruparai, to see a place I hadn't ever been to, even though I have spent years in Delhi. It is amazing to see the vast expanse of forest land in the heart of Delhi, in the area well known as Mehroli. And this place is really where it all started. The earliest surviving fort of Delhi as we know it, the Rai Pithora, also known as the Lal Kot.
We are in a place steeped in history. This is perhaps the oldest part of Delhi as we know it, the oldest surviving fort, tracing its origins to anywhere between the 8th and 10th century. Behind me is the main gate of the Lal Kot, the Tomar stronghold, and around me is the citadel. Also right here, over here, as you can see, is perhaps the oldest grave of a Muslim peer in India.
While there are those who contest whether this grave is indeed the oldest, Vikramjit says it is still significant. These walls around the grave, built between the 8th and 12th century CE, give us a peek into the early pre-Islamic history of Delhi. The original fortification of Lal Kot was built by the Tomar king Anangpal, and this was their center between the 8th and 10th century CE. It came under the Chauhans by the 12th century CE, and the famous king Prithviraj Chauhan extended the fortification. The Kila Rai Pithora, as it came to be named, was a powerful post, and it was from here that the Muslim army of Muhammad Ghor, under his general Qutubuddin Aibak, marched into Delhi. This was after the Second Battle of Tarai, when Chauhan was defeated by Ghori. Tarai or Tarori was near present-day Thanesar in Haryana, around a four-hour drive away.
From this mound, you can see what would have been the famous Ranjit Gate that the army of Muhammad of Ghor marched through, led by Qutubuddin Aibak.
We are standing on the Ranjit Gate. When we talk about gate, somehow this perception comes that there would be some sort of arched gate and elephants would be passing under it. But we are talking about 9th and 10th century. We did not have concept of building true arches back then. There were corbel arches, there were trebiate arches, but it was not possible to construct such a huge structure. So what these people did, they created a gate something like this. So we have got a bastion over there, this is one, and then there is the citadel wall. Army would actually march in, go in the S shape to enter the fort, and the army was trying to protect. If this is the invading army, they would keep huge vessels with boiling oil or some sort of boulders or stones over here, and they would, this is a very narrow stretch, and at any given point of time, four or five men can in a row walk in, and you can easily kill them or you can easily block them from here. So this is the Ranjit Gate, which was later renamed to Ghazni Gate.
What we see as forest here would have been very different 1,000 years back. In fact, Mehroli itself is very historic.
Reference to Mehroli, we've got multiple stories behind this. If I talk about Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan, because he is considered as one of the authorities who has written one of the oldest vernacular documentation on Delhi, was done by him in the form of Asar Sanadid. In that, he mentions that there is a possibility that Mehroli has been named Mehroli because of Mehre Wali. So there is a shrine of Khwaja Qutubuddin Bakhtiyar Kaki Rahmatullahi, and he's considered as one of the Walis. So there is a possibility. However, we do have references, much older references, in Jain Patavlis, where this place is mentioned as Mihirapuri. Then we also have a reference of Varaha Mihir, who in somewhere in 3rd or 4th century CE came to this place and he established his observatory over here, where he also wrote Panch Siddhant and a lot of documentation, because Chinese travelers came here and there were other people who came and who documented that, and they mentioned that there is a sun temple. So Mihir is sun. So there is a sun temple and the area is known as Mihirapuri. Much later, when Anangpal came, so one theory got associated with him as well. They said that since he is one of the descendants, distant descendants of Raja Mihir Bhoj, so he has kept the name of the city as Mihre Ali, or I welcome Mihir, or the footsteps of Mihir.
Sadly, despite its great history, very little of Lal Kot has actually been excavated. Mounds like this hide many secrets, and very few of the thousands of tourists who come to the nearby Qutub Minar venture to this site. Even though this is probably from where Qutubuddin Aibak, Delhi's first Sultan, would have looked out to decide on where to build his pillar of victory.